देयर इज नो डिनाइंग द फैक्ट दैट मैन इज पॉलीगेमस बाय नेचर. मोनोगैमी इज सिंपली फोर्स्ड अपॉन हिम. मैनी प्रॉब्लम्स अराइज इन मैरिटल रिलेशनशिप्स सिंपली बिकॉज देयर इज नो एक्सेप्टेंस आर एप्रिशिएशन ऑफ प्री मैरिटल आर एक्स्ट्रा मैरिटल सेक्स. इट इज ऑल्सो आर गुड दैट फॉर चूजिंग ए राइट लाइफ पार्टनर वन शुड हैव एक्सपीरियंस्ड ए फ्यू मैन एंड वीमेन इन लाइफ. ऑल दिस साइकोलॉजिस्ट यूनानिमसली होल्ड दैट प्री मैरिटल सेक्स इज यूजफुल फॉर द साइकोलॉजिकल ग्रोथ एंड मेच्योरिटी ऑफ एवरी पर्सन एंड देयरफॉर इट विल प्रूव यूजफुल फॉर देयर मैरिटल ब्लिस. अकॉर्डिंग टू देम ऑल द लविंग कपल्स शुड हैव लव अफेयर्स वंस इन ए व्हाइल हियर एंड देयर. दिस विल रिन्यू एंड रिफ्रेश देयर रिलेशनशिप एंड इट विल एड वीगर एंड एनर्जी टू इट. इट विल एनहांस द ब्यूटी एंड इंटीमेसी बिटवीन द कपल्स. एंड आई हैव टू टेल यू दैट फॉर द ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑफ द सेक्स एनर्जी इन टू स्पिरिचुअल एनर्जी यू आर रिक्वायर्ड टू ट्रांसेंड द बायोलॉजिकल अर्ज विदाउट एनी एफर्ट. बट यू कैन नॉट ट्रांसेंड इट इफ यू आर रिप्रेसिव ऑफ द नेचुरल अर्ज. Finally, premarital sex has been gaining acceptance all over the world globally. 95% of the Americans do not wait until the wedding night. Waiting for the sex until the wedding night means early marriages and conservative views on marriage, but both these situations lead to unhappiness and divorce in marriages. In view of these facts, honeymoon before marriages becomes inevitable. However, our approach until now has been to promote abstinence or chastity before marriage and to condemn premarital sex. One man, one woman principle has been the normal practice all over the globe, and this was intended to stabilize the society. Secondly, sex drive remains at the maximum between 13 years and 20 years of age, when this drive is purely physical, devoid of any emotional content. It has also been argued that, like other animals, after attaining the age of puberty, humans should also go for sex. It is quite natural at this stage to indulge in sex. However, human society is expected to behave as something more than being animalistic. It must stand for something more than eating, sleeping, reproducing, and then dying one day. It must stand for something more than merely eating, sleeping, reproducing, and then dying one day. It has been rightly expressed that at a time when physicality is at its peak, people become so much sex-driven that they fail to discriminate, and then they may go for sex even with their own brothers or sisters. Hence, a certain order and discipline is required in the sex life of the youth. And if it is not taken care of, human societies will not go better than animal societies. However, I have to say that whenever there is an absence of overwhelming sexual drive, simply saying do not do it will not suffice. Something is genuinely required to deal with the over-sexuality that catches the youth like wildfire. Up till now, two methods have been tried: preaching and repression. But preaching and repression, both these methods have failed. Because of our condemnation and repression of sex, sex has become poisoned, and the same has given birth to over-sexuality in humanity. But sexuality exists only in humans. That is why humans are always sexual in every situation, but animals are not. They have their own seasons. The whole essence of my life experience is that if humanity is to be freed of over-sexuality, it is necessary to create a new door for the flow of life energy or sex energy before the door of sex opens. And this new door is the door of meditation. Meditation must be made mandatory for children from the early years, that is from 10 to 12 years of age. Teaching them antagonism to sex is absolutely foolish. Instead, they must be taught something positive. Meditation is the only and the best thing that can be offered to them that can serve the purpose. And the beauty of the whole thing lies in the fact that they can attain to meditation faster because the door to sex energy is still not open. That is closed. And therefore, that energy is available in abundance, and the same can be used for opening the new door of meditation. At an older age, the same task will become too difficult for them. Once the door of sex has opened, it becomes very difficult to open the new door. It becomes difficult just because it is the nature of energy that once it has started flowing along a certain path, it continues to flow through that path continuously. Once the Ganges has taken its course, it continues to flow along that path continuously. It does not change the path every day. Therefore, initiate children into meditation at the age of 10 to 12 years. This will put an end to the possibility of over-sexuality in the youth because their energy would have found the new path. They would have experienced something much deeper, something more joyful and pleasurable than sex. You will not be required to control them. They will learn to live consciously, and in the process, they will learn automatically to move into sex also consciously. And then the whole problem would be resolved. Children can learn to meditate very, very quickly if they are encouraged and offered facilities for the same. 1 hour daily sitting in silence must be made compulsory in every home. Let there be a rule that a home can go without meal in an emergency, but no home should go without an hour of meditation. Otherwise, that home will not remain a home at all. If this is not done, the modern youth will not be left with any option except free sex with all its undesirable consequences. It's not an issue of morality. I have offered a scientific process for upgrading the human consciousness so that humanity can live a better, happier, and most intelligent life on this planet. Now, it depends on you as to what you want to choose, intelligence or indulgence.